The Miniature Pinscher is often seen as the king of the toy variety of breeds, and for several good reasons. In this video, we'll go over why Min Pins have run away with this dubious distinction, and present to you all kinds of other facts that will fuel your appreciation for the breed. Build. A typical miniature pinscher will often grow to about 13 inches tall and can weigh up to 10 pounds. Min Pins have a gait that would remind onlookers of a horse having a high-stepping way of walking called a hackney gait. Coats and colours. This breed can be found in a variety of colours. Their coats can be chocolate and tan, red, black and rust, black and tan, stag red, and chocolate and rust. Grooming requirements for their smooth, short coat are low with this little breed, only requiring an occasional brushing as they are moderate shedders. Bathing should only be kept to a minimum, as Min Pins tend to be easily irritated by shampoos and conditioners. Exercise and diet. It should also be noted that Min Pins are high-energy dogs that exhibit a seemingly endless supply, which will require a diet ready for a calorie-burner breed. Some dogs tend to exercise or play and then rest. The Miniature Pinscher wants to play, then rest in order to play again. A different mindset. Several bouts of energy and play are necessary throughout the day with this breed to burn that energy and to keep the pup happy. The Kings of the Toys. The Mini Pinscher is called the King of the Toys because of their upright or royal appearance, noble demeanor, and unwavering confidence. Though this is a complimentary title, it doesn't take much for it to get to the breed's head. Without early set guidance, a Mini Pinscher will proudly assume the role of alpha dog, cementing its rule over its kingdom. They have no problem doing whatever they feel like doing and will often obey an owner when they decide to rather than as an act of obedience. A literal and convincing example of small dog syndrome. Small children and Mini Pins don't mix. As is true with all breeds, there are some exceptions to the rule. However, this rule is well justified when talking about kids and Min Pins. Being a toy breed comes with many dangers, and small children are included as a cause for some of these dangers. Although this is a well-built and hearty breed, miniature pinschers are prone to be easily injured when not being handled properly, or fall prey to the simple wrong place, wrong time accidents. The Miniature Pinscher isn't a pint-sized Doberman. These pups look strikingly similar to a Doberman Pinscher, but they're not a toy variety of the original article. Both breeds have completely separate sets of ancestral beginnings. Why do Mini Pinschers attack small objects? Miniature Pinschers attack small and loose objects as a means to play, but originates from their instinctual desires to capture and kill things smaller than themselves. Without careful training and attention by owners, the Min Pin might decide to go after other small pet animals and treating them as prey. And of boldness in a tiny package. As we talked about earlier in this video, miniature pinschers are seemingly endless balls of energy. Accompanying this default energetic position is a boldness that rivals other breeds its size or even larger. Among the many accolades that come with this breed are fearlessness, confidence, and boldness. Miniature pinschers are moderately trainable, and traits such as fearlessness and boldness will need to be curbed as soon as possible. They are escape artists. Min Pins are small, agile, and can leap over things with ease. Aside from that, they are always willing to overcome challenges, and that's where their escape artistry comes into play. When penned in, they already go through the motions of determining any possible escape route around, over, underneath, through, or between. In many ways, it's an exercise of mental stimulation for the dog, which is unfortunate for owners looking to keep their dogs within the boundaries of a fenced yard. When you strip down any pitfalls or tough-to-manage traits of the breed, you will wind up with a loving, loyal companion who will always be ready to share company with its owners. Perhaps a little tough to train, but as many owners would testify, well worth the effort. Have you ever owned a miniature pinscher? Or have you ever had any personal experiences with one? Please leave a comment below. And as always, I'd like to remind you, please leave me a like and subscribe to the channel to receive my latest videos about your favourite breeds. Thanks for watching!